When it comes to power cards, when it comes to your best cards, when it comes to your most powerful cards, your cards you need to see as fast as possible, your Pompoko, Obedience Guild, you know, these are the best cards in your deck. You need to see them turn one. You need to see them turn one. How, at which ratio should you play those? You play them at three. I mean this without any sense of hyperbole or any sense of exaggeration. This is such a shit deck. This is so bad. It takes effort to be this bad at the game and bad at deck building. I don't know what you're trying to do here. It's very simple deck building. Do you want to go first? Or do you want to go second? See this card. See this card on screen. Do you see this card? See this card here? Do you see this card here? Okay. See this card? This card is the best card in your deck. Okay. This is the strongest single card in your deck. Okay? You've decided to play two of it. Why is there only two Obedience Guild in your deck? Why is there only two Obedience Guild in your deck? It bricks at three. She's in the chat, guys. Chloe says that Obedience Guild bricks at three. Let me explain something here to everyone, okay? Pay attention. We're being completely serious, all right? I'm going to teach you all something. This is probably the most important thing you will ever see in your Yu-Gi-Oh career. This here. This is called a hypergeometric calculator. All of you, pay attention. Look at the screen. This is the most important part of any video you will ever watch on any part of the internet, okay? Population size. 40. This is the number of cards in your deck, okay? Number of successes in population. This is how many cards are in your deck. How many copies of that card are in your deck, okay? Three. You have three Obedience Guild in your deck, okay? There are three Obedience Guild in your deck, correct? Your sample size is five, okay, Chloe? Because you're going first. You're going first with your furry agenda. All right, the furry agenda wants to go first. It wants to make Obedience Guild. It wants to make a Nat Beast, and it wants to, like, set a mistake. Set a strike or something, set a judgment, and just pass. You know, Sandayu, Nat Beast, that's game versus, like, the meta, right? That's what you want to do. Okay? So, number of successes in sample. That's the number of, that's the chance of opening that Obedience Guild in your hand of five cards. One. Okay? We're going to open one. Let's see. Calculate. Hypergeometric probability, X equal to or greater than one. Okay? See this here? 0.33. Multiply it by 100 to get the percent. 33%. The chances of opening Obedience Guild in your opening hand in a 40-card deck of 5 cards in your hand in a 40-card deck is 33%. That's the chance of you opening one of your Obedience Guild. The chances of you opening two of your Obedience Guild is 0.03. Multiply this by 100. That's 3%. The chances of you opening two Obedience Guild in your hand is 3%. A.K.A. I.E. Not a brick. Not a brick. Now, if we play two Obedience Guild in our deck, which is the number of successes in population, we bring that down to two. The number of successes in the sample, which is the card in your hand, one. What's the chances of it? 23%. You're trading off 10%. In order for you to brick 2% less, you're reducing your consistency by 10%. Let me draw you a fucking graph. Just so all of you can understand, this is why two ofs make no sense. This is why two ofs make absolutely no sense whatsoever. Okay, it is mathematically sound to never play a card at two. Chance of opening one three of. Okay, that chance is 33%. Chance of opening one two of. Okay. The chance of opening one two of is 23%. Chance of opening two of the same three of is 3%. 3%. Chance of opening the same two of 2%. This reduction is a minus 10% consistency. And this here, what you've done is you've gained plus 1% Consistency. Yeah, you're gaining consistency because you're bricking less, right? So mathematically, all you've really gained is a net surplus. Sorry, you've made a net, you've lost a net surplus of, let's see who the brainy ones here are. What's the total here that you've lost? 9%. 9%. Okay? There you go. So you have made your deck 9% less consistent. It is mathematically incorrect to play a 2 of. Okay? It doesn't make sense. An unsearchable non-engine 3 of should be played at 3. It is a mathematical fact. You're losing 10% consistency to gain 1% consistency. If you feel that you're drawing your double desires too often, if you feel that you're drawing your double obedience school too often, that's just your brain remembering the bad times, and it doesn't remember the times that you drew it 10% more often, because you're going to draw these cards 10% more often, but you're going to brick with them 1% more often. I'm bricking 1% less, but I'm not seeing the most powerful card in my deck 10% less of the time. 1 in 10 games, I'm going to see that card less. If you play an unsearchable non-engine 3 of at anything less than 3, unless it's your 38th or 39th card, or 40th card rather, you know, if you're just trying to fill up space, if you just have a random Cosmic Cyclone, if you have a random, I don't know, Raigeki or Twin Twister in there because you literally cannot find anything else to put in your deck to make it nice and round up to 40, you've ran out of card ideas, fine. You can play a 1 of, a 2 of, it's fine in that scenario. But when it comes to power cards, when it comes to your best cards, when it comes to your most powerful cards, your cards you need to see as fast as possible, your Pompoko, Obedience Schooled, you know, these are the best cards in your deck. You need to see them turn 1. You need to see them turn 1. How, at which ratio should you play those? You play them at 3. This is fact. Mathematical fact. This is indisputable maths. You'd play them at 4. Even if it was a 4 of, you'd play it at 4. Because the maths just makes sense. Okay? So I believe you asked about what about going second. So it's very simple. When you go second, all you need to do is change this number, the sample size, to 6. Alright? Because this is your hand size. Number of successes in sample, 1. And we're playing 3 Obedience Schooled in our deck. The chances of opening Obedience Schooled in our deck, going second, goes up to 40%, 39%, okay, 39%. So chances of opening 1-3 of is 40%, right? The chances of opening 2 Obedience Schooled, going second, if you play at 3, is 5%. Now, if we change that to 2 Obedience Schooled in our deck and we only draw 1, the chances of it, of us drawing 1 is 28%, okay? And the chances of us drawing both our Obedience Schooled is 1%, okay? So now we have gained 4% consistency, but by playing at 3 going second, we have gained, I can't do maths, 40 take away 28 is 12%, 12%. So that is a surplus of 8%, okay? 12 take away 4. 8%. It becomes slight, it gets 1% more inconsistent going second. That's the only difference. Be honest in chat. If you used to play Desires at 2, or if you used to play Obedience Schooled, or all of these powerful cards at 2, admit it right now in the chat, and please tell me, have I convinced you otherwise? Has the maths convinced you otherwise? Okay? This is mathematical proof. Mathematical evidence, okay, that you need to play your cards at 3. Have I convinced you? Yes or no? Have I convinced you? I fucking hate all of you. I hate every single one of you. All of you are pieces of shit. Every single one of you is a cunt. I hate all of you. Fuck this. I went through all of this shit and you're just like, I always do sometimes, but not all the time. Everything at 2, it evens out. I'm this close to banning you, Chloe. I'm this close to banning you. Don't push me. Lol, nice math, nerd. Ah. I went through all of that to be called a nerd. Would you play it at 2 because you'll usually never use it more than once? So if you have more afterwards, people think it bricks. No, but it's like Brilliant Fusion, right? Yeah, you activate the first Brilliant Fusion. It's dead after the first one, right? You're never going to activate it again. Unless you're playing actual Gem Knights, right? But it doesn't matter. The card is so good that you're going to win within the first turn or two. Alright, so you need to play it ASAP. Cards that are searchable don't fall under this category. I just want to make that very clear. Cards that can be searched, engine cards, engine requirements, all of these cards, you know, they don't count in this, right? This is primarily talking about power cards, okay? This was back when Soul Charge was at 3, for example. Some people played 2. I stupidly, when I first started playing, I played Soul Charge at 2 because it bricks at 3, right? That was my logic. But it's wrong, okay? Because the chance of it breaking is only 1% more than if it was at 2. Now, obviously, it doesn't count things where you're just trying to fill up the rest of your deck. You know, you've decided on your 37 cards, you can't think of anything else. Or, like, you have 39 cards, you can't think of anything else. I'll just put in a cyclone, a cosmic cyclone, okay? But if your logic and if your reasoning for playing a card at less than 3 is that, oh, it bricks, you're mathematically wrong. Just subscribe, give me money. It's for the greater good, trust me.